And we're go in 3, 2, 1.
That's not making it to the B-roll. If you are an educator that is using Canvas for your classes, then this video is for you. If you haven't seen any of my videos before, my name is Ashlee Espinosa. I have an MFA in musical theater, and here on my YouTube channel, I do videos for educators, actors, and directors, just like myself, a multi-hyphenate artist. I got this question from quite a lot of people the past couple of weeks, so I thought it would be really helpful to make a video out of it. If you are creating an assignment that is a listening project or a video watching project, and then you want them to watch something or listen to something, and then respond with either answering questions or creating an essay out of it, or creating some type of response that they're going to submit to you for a grade. If this video is helpful for you, please consider it giving a like, a thumbs up down over here over on the side. It really helps my channel, and it also helps me find folks out there just like you that these videos would be really, really helpful for. Also, if you want to see more videos, don't forget to click the subscribe button so you don't miss any videos at all. All right, let's get started. Okay, so go into your Canvas shell. We're gonna do this as an assignment, and I'm gonna show you two different options that you have. This is my preferred option, but I'm gonna show you a way that you can use it as a quiz or an exam if that's really your choice and your preference. So the first thing you wanna do is obviously go into assignments, click assignments. You want to go to the top right in the blue button, and of course, create an assignment. All right, here we are. We're gonna make this an assignment. So I'm gonna call it 2010s Musical Research. So here's the description. I want them to listen to the three songs that I'm about to input right in here. And then I want them to answer three questions to analyze all of these three songs. Now this can be a audio file, a video file, something that you want them to use. I teach musical theater and theater, but if you teach in any subject, you may want them to listen to something and respond, or watch something and respond, and this is a great way to do it. So I wrote the instructions. This is the basic instructions. And then I'm going to now write the questions that I want them to answer. So I'm going to enter down here, and I'm going to click the numbered list. And here's question number one. So I would list the three questions that I want them to answer. And then now I'm going to go in, and I am going to put in the links that I want them to listen to. Okay, so I find the song I want. I'm going to, here's the link. I'm going to copy this link, and I'm going to go over here, and I'm going to click insert or edit media. Click on that, edit, paste into this link, okay, and click OK. And then it will pop up the YouTube link here. Now, if you're wanting to do an album or a listening project without the video as well, all you have to do is find the album on YouTube. The reason why I like YouTube is because it's not taking up any of your memory in Canvas, and it also is going to be easy for the student to click in and stream without them having to go to another file. They can literally just go in here, click play, and the video will play right there in Canvas. I'm going to then go through and find a few other songs that I want them to listen to. Okay, so I've went ahead and put all three in Canvas. You can see here's one, here's two, and here's three. So I've got all the videos or the listening projects. If I just wanted it to be an album, I would just copy the album. Then I want to go down here. You also, another option you have too is if you want to ask different questions about different songs, I would say after every video, insert the questions below. And that way there's different questions for different videos if you want to play it up. But I just want them to answer the three same questions for all three videos. Go down here, put how many points you want it to be. Let's say I want this to be 100. What group assignment this is going to be, I would actually create a new group and call it perhaps listening projects. Then I would do how many points I want it to be. I like it to be typically in percentage, but you may also want it to be a complete or incomplete, meaning they just have to do it or not do it. And if they do it, they get a thumbs up. If they don't do it, they get a zero. Sometimes that's really helpful for the classes we're doing right now with all of this moving to online so quickly as well. So let's do complete and complete. Okay, I do want it to count towards the final grade. Now this is the important part. They're going to submit this online, and they're going to do a text entry box. This is going to pop up for them where they see the content of the assignment, and then they're going to have a box that they have to then type in and fill in. You also have another option down here. You can click file upload instead, and they can write a PDF, and then they can attach that PDF for you. That's another option you have too. That's typically what I do if it's a longer essay, But if it's just something really quick and simple, a text box is good. Really just depends on, you know, your preference. So I'm gonna click text box, and then I'm gonna go down here. I don't wanna do any of that. There's not a group assignment. Everyone, I'd put the date on here, and then I'd put, so let's say it is due by this day, and then I'm gonna give them availability. Now, I would really encourage you to give them more than just a day or more than just 48 hours because you don't know when they're gonna have internet access, or they may, the quiet time that they have to do this assignment may be in the middle of the night. So you really wanna be accessible to all friends. I typically give them a week. That gives them the weekdays. And then if they're working, also it gives them the weekend to really complete it on the time that's best for the student. So let's go ahead and just give them a week. Let's say we do it from now, and let's say we have it until Sunday. When you're ready, click the save button at the bottom. You can click publish if you're ready to publish as well, but I'd like to just to click save so I can see how it looks before I publish it to the students. I have my questions. I would also go ahead and describe a little more briefly in here that they're going to put it in the text box, or if you want them to do a PDF, give them more information than necessary right here. Do you want it to be in all sentences? Do you want it to be in bullet points? Maybe give them a little more description, but here's an overview. So here's the three videos. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and publish this now. This looks great. So I'm gonna click publish, okay? And then it will pop up for the student. The next thing I wanna do is go into the student view, and I want to make sure that they can see it and that it all looks good. So I'm gonna go into the student view. I'm going to look at the assignments, and then I'm gonna make sure, okay, here it is. It is closed already, but that's because it's an old class. So here it is. I can see that I wanna submit by a text box, the dates, the assignment, the videos are here, okay? And it all looks really, really good. If you create this as a quiz, all you would do is input it as a video question, and then it would still be timed. The reason why I really don't like it to be timed is because they're going to have to think and watch that timer tick down. So I really suggest that you make it an assignment. But again, your choice, your preference. If you want to do that, just go over here to the left, click quiz, okay? Then you would create a new quiz. When you go over to the quiz now, do your instructions in here just like you would normally. If you miss the quiz one, I will link it up in the cards right here for you now on how to create a quiz. But we want to then do a question. So we'll make it a graded quiz. We'll put this in exams. Now you do have the option of making it not timed. So if you want it to be a quiz that's not timed and you want them to fill it out, that's another option you have as well. So you'd go over here to new question, click on new question, okay? And I wanna make this a video. So again, I click the video, I would copy and paste the link that I wanted to, and I would click okay. And here's the video question that I want them to answer, okay? Now let's say that I don't want to be multiple choice. I want to go in and I want it to be an essay question. So I'm gonna click essay question, okay? And then it's gonna give them a box that they can fill in. So let's update the question. So here is the video that they watch, and they will be able to fill it in as a text box. So I can click save, and then I can see that if I preview it, it is going to pop up here and you're going to see the video, and then you're gonna have this text box down here that the student can write their answer in. This is another way that you have to do it. It's not going to give you a timer over here. You can see, because I didn't set the timer, it's just gonna go up for them. And then when they're done with all the questions, answering all of them, they can submit it. So those are a couple of options that you have. You can either do what I prefer, which is making it an assignment for a listening project, or if you want it to be timed, then you can do the quiz option. It can be untimed in the quiz option. You have that format, but what's really helpful for you is, as a teacher, you can then go through and see their answers and grade them in SpeedGrader and give them notes and offer feedback. But it's really going to be easy for you to grade everything at once and have all of these assignments in one place. I hope this video helped you. If it did, please give it a like up, a thumbs up. Leave me a message in the comments if you have any questions, or if you discovered something perhaps that I didn't discover or cover today. It's always helpful to share information in our community as educators and artists. Have a great week. If you need anything, please let me know. Don't hesitate to reach out and ask, and I will see you in the next video. All right, bye.